Assalamu alaikum. Welcome all to Easy Hem and Anatomy channel. In this video, I discuss the ligamentum denticulatum. Denticulate ligament is triangular in shape. This is the base of the ligamentum denticulatum. This is the apex of the ligamentum denticulatum. They are situated along the length of the spinal cord and situated at each side of the spinal cord. The spinal cord is covered by the from within outwards pyameter, arachnoid matter and dura mater. This is the subarachnoid space. The pyameter is a vascular membrane that closely covers the spinal cord and thickens in each side between the two roots of the spinal nerves and from the ligamentum denticulatum. So this ligamentum denticulatum is cross the subarachnoid space, arachnoid matter, and apex of the ligamentum denticulum is attached with the dura mater. This is the base of the denticulate ligament. This is the apex of the denticulated ligament. So base is arise in the pyameter and the apex is attached with the dura mater. So this is the base and this is the apex and this is the dura mater. The denticulate ligaments cross the subarachnoid space between the anterior and posterior nerves root and spares the arachnoid matter and connect to the two sides of the spinal cord to the dura mater. This is the base of the denticulated ligaments is from a unbroken line along the spinal cord from foramen magnum to the conus medullaris. The lateral edge of the denticulate ligaments has series of tooth-like position which is attached to the dura mater between the two successive nerves roots. The number of the denticulate ligaments is 21 pair, but the number is vary from 18 to 24 pairs. This is the base of the denticulate ligament. This is the apex of a denticulate ligament. The triangular extensions are smaller and more numerous at the cervical region, but larger and less numerous at the thoracic region. The apices of the extension is attached to the dura mater by a fibrous band at cervical length. Their length is 3 to 5 millimeter, but at lower thoracic levels its length is 21 to 26 millimeter. The highest denticulate ligament is attached to the dura mater just above the foramen magnum behind the vertebral artery. This is the vertebral artery and in front of the spinal root of the accessory nerve. So this is the accessory nerve. So this is the first denticulated ligament which is situated in front of the accessory nerves and behind the vertebral artery. The lowest denticulated ligament lies between the 12th thoracic and first lumbar spinal nerve roots, and it is a narrow oblique band that descends laterally from the conus medullaris. The stability of the spinal cord is served by the denticulate ligaments and the phylum terminally, the extension of the pyameter and attachment of the nerve roots. Denticulate ligaments in MRI scan. This is the cross section of the vertebral column. This is cross section of the spinal cord, inner gray matter, outer white matter. So inner gray matter, outer white matter, and these are the covering of the spinal cord, pyometer, arachnoid, and dura mater and subarachnoid space. This is the denticulate ligaments. This is the ventral root. This is the dorsal root, and this is the denticulate ligament. This is the apex of the denticulate ligament. This is the base of the denticulate ligament. So here, this is the denticulate ligament. This is the apex of the denticulate ligament. This is the base of the denticulate ligament. This is the ventral root. This is the dorsal root with dorsal root ganglia. The changes in the form and position of the denticulate ligaments can be examined by seen radiography. The process of making radiograph of movement object in sufficiently rapid sequence so that the radiograph or copy made from them may be projected as a motion picture. So the position change of the denticulated ligament during spinal movement can be scanned by the seen radiography. You show the positions of the denticulate ligaments is observed during the spinal movement. Clinical anatomy. Denticulate ligaments are characterized by the highly extensibility on average 50% of their initial length and relatively low force necessary to rupture them. The average ultimate force that broke the denticulate ligaments was 0.88N. The two strain characteristics of the denticulate ligaments are different at different vertebral level. Their strains are more especially in cervical region, decrease in caudal orientation. The significant difference exists between the cervical 1 and cervical 7. The force that broke the denticulate ligament in cervical 1 is 1N, but in cervical 7 is 0.55N. So this is all about denticulate ligament. If you feel this video is helpful for you, please press the like button and please subscribe my channel, and please ask any questions regarding this video. I can very much happy to answer the questions.